Let's say you have this 1 over s plus 3 and s plus 1. Okay. Now, by the way, to do this, you have to have a 1 on top. It's not a big deal if you don't. If you don't have a 1, pull it out front, okay? It's 3s, pull the 3s out front, and you have a 1 there. Now, what I observed when I did these, not when I first did them, of course. I don't know when I realized this, but it really wasn't when I was a beginning student. I know I have to have that. I kind of thought, well, what if I do when I go backwards? Well, if I were to go here, I'd have to multiply this. You don't need to write this part down here. I'm just showing you what I would think in my head. I'd have s plus 1, right, to get back to here. LCD is s plus 3. Okay. Then I kind of look at the top, and I'm thinking, well, I'd have this and this, right? I need a 1 on top, right? And so I think, well, I have a 3 and I have a 1. How can I get that? Well, they're off by 2, right? They're 2 off from each other. So what I kind of figured out here is that I could just do this. Now, I'm not quite done yet. Now, here's my thinking behind it. Is that this is 3 halves, right? This would be 1 half. Just looking at the number part. And if I subtract them, 3 halves minus 1 half, I get 2 halves, which is 1, right? Now, that really wasn't my main motivation in doing that. What I was really looking for at first was to get rid of the s's, because I don't have an s here, right? So one of these is going to have to be negative. And if I look at it, well, this is 1 half, this is 3 halves, right? This is the one that's going to be negative, okay? Somebody looking at this and going, what the hell is he doing, right? I understand that. It is a little weird at first, but usually you're going to see the pattern here once you do it a couple times. And as I always say, if you don't like it, you can do partial fractions, okay? And some people don't like this at all. They just don't understand it. They don't see it, and that's fine. Go ahead and do partial fractions. What happens here if I multiply? I have a negative 1 half s, right? And then I have a 1 half s. This is why I want opposite signs for the same number. So I don't want an s, I don't have an s here. Up here I have 3 halves, and this would be negative 1 half. And 3 halves minus 1 half is 2 halves, which is 1, right? Now, the pattern you want to notice here is I really looked at these two. Actually, I should include that part there as well. How far off are they? Well, they're off by 2, right? This is where my 1 half is 1 over the distance they're apart. And that has to happen because I'm going to have 3 halves here, right? And I'm going to have 1 half. You notice I'm taking the 3 and the 1? The 3 and the 1 is giving me 2, which is going to match the 2 on the bottom, right? That's where this is coming from. So very quickly, I come up with a partial fraction. I'll give you another one. Now, the thing about this is these have to match this form. If I have s squared plus 3 and s plus 1, you're not going to be able to do this. So these factors have to be the same. They don't have to be s plus plus. They have to be the same, though. So I might have something like this. S squared plus 4 and s squared minus 3, let's say. So I know I have s squared plus 4. Here I have s squared minus 3. Okay, you want to look at the number. Now, let's say I circled that because negative 3 is a number, okay? It's plus a negative 3. How far off are they? Well, they're 7 apart, right? So I know this has to be 1/7 up here. One of them is going to be negative. The way to figure that out is to kind of think here. Well, I'm going to multiply. You want to focus on the numbers because the s squared will drop out, right? S squared minus 3 is what you multiply this by, right? S squared minus 3 over itself. Here, s squared plus 4 over itself. So really, this is going to multiply here, this multiplied here. Well, here I get negative 3/7, and here I get 4/7. In your mind, you want 1. Well, 1 means 7/7, right? So this is 4 sevenths, and this is negative 3 sevenths. I probably want this to be negative, right? Let's take a look at y. If I multiply this, I get negative 1 seventh s squared. 1 seventh s squared. So the s squared will go away. Here I get 3 sevenths. Here I get 4 sevenths. And I have 7 sevenths, right? And that's it. And you're done with your partial fraction, just like that. Let me talk about a couple other things. This is the main idea. Now, you have to have this form. These have to match up now to do this. But you may not have this form. Well, the next question is, well, can you make it that form? Sometimes you can. So maybe you have something that is like this. You have 1 over s times s squared plus 4. And you're going, well, I can't do that, right? Because that's an s squared. Okay? This is not going to work. It's not going to work. Well, maybe we can make it an s squared, right? So what I could do is write this as s over s squared times s squared plus 4, right? Same thing if that's 1 over s, right? Now again, I need to have a 1 on top to do this. What I really do, I'm going to pull the s out, and then I'll be left with 1 over s squared times s squared plus 4, right? Now this matches what I'm talking about. So if I do that now, I know this is s squared. I know this is s squared plus 4. Now this is plus 0, right? So 0 and 4 are 4 parts, so this should be 1 fourth. This should be 1 fourth. Again, you're trying to get 1. Well, you think, look at the number. I get 1 fourth times 1, right? That's right, 1 fourth times 4 is 1. So this has got to be the negative here. So I get 1. I get 1 fourth s squared. I get minus 1 fourth s squared. They drop out, and that's it. Now what about this s? Well, what you're going to do is you're going to bring it back in again, right? So you'd have 1 fourth over s, right? Minus 1 fourth times s over s squared plus 4. And you notice, you know this transform, right? This is 1 over this. You can take the inverse transform of that, take the inverse transform of that, and you're done, right? So oftentimes you can kind of make it work, even if it doesn't appear to be that way to begin with. So let me kind of show you one more. There's tons of these, right? I'm just giving you a few different examples. This is what you want to think before you jump into a problem. Kind of look at it and see if you can manipulate it to work out to something that you like. So I'll give you one more. Think of something that is like this, kind of the opposite problem to the one above. And I think, well, s squared is not going to work, right? Well, I don't want to multiply by s minus 3 over s minus 3. That's not the same form, right? What you can do here is, well, get rid of that one. And then I would have that, right? Now this matches that form. So what I could do at this point, I have 1 over s, and then we could split this up. S minus 3. And that's 0, and that's negative 3, so they're off by 3. This is 1 third, this is 1 third. Now I want 1, right? Negative 3 times 1 third is negative 1. Well, I don't want that. This has to be negative, right? Negative 3 times negative 1 third is 1. Of course, I get negative 1 third s. 1 third s, that's 0, they drop out, right? Now bring it back in again, and what we're going to get here, let me kind of go over here. I'm going to have negative 1 third times 1 over s squared. Now we know the transform of that, right? Then we get 1 third times 1 over s times s minus 3. What do we do about this now, right? I have this again. Well, we just did that right here, right? So I can just basically take what I did right here. So you would end up with this negative 1 third times 1 over s squared plus 1 third. Now, this part here, remember, is this. So I just replace this with negative 1 third over s plus 1 third over s minus 3, right? Now if we multiply this out, what you end up with is this. You have negative 1 third 1 over s squared minus 1/9 1 over s plus 1/9 1 over s minus 3. So you have this, you have this, you have this. We know the inverse transform of all of those. Okay?
That's it. If you find the video is helpful, feel free to give it a like, share, and subscribe to my channel in order to receive the most current videos. Don't forget to hit the bell so that you won't miss anything. I'll see you next time.